The Maryland Sire Stakes program not only showcases the 2 and 3-year-olds of the first state, but there are races featuring equines of ages 4 and 5. So let's congratulate the winners of those events from Ocean Downs. First, we'll check out the 4 and 5-year-old female trotters in their event from Berlin, Maryland.
High step by 5/8 and head to 3/4, yet to face a challenge, Ga Ga Gone. Gearing up from the pocket is Boo Boo Ba Ba, and closing along the inside is Whitesville Shirley. 3/4, 1:30 and 4. Head into the far turn for the final time, and Ga Ga Gone has carved up all the numbers. It's a length and a half. Boo Boo Ba Ba continues to follow in her hoof print second. 2 lengths back to Whitesville Shirley. Farther back, Spiffin Spiffy. Less than an eighth to trot. They're on their way home. Ga Ga Gone along the inside from the pocket. Here comes Boo Boo Ba Ba. Boo Boo Ba Ba. Bye bye. Wins at 3/4 of a length.
Boo Boo Ba Ba got a great trip and got up to win in 2:01 with Eddie Davis Jr. at the controls for owner Dolly Callahan of Breakaway Racing Stable. And Dolly's husband, Nick Callahan, is the breeder. At the wire, the daughter of Goo Goo Gaga was able to catch her stablemate, Gaga Gone, who is also a daughter of Goo Goo Gaga. Did you get all of that? Well, let's learn a little more about these mares from their trainer, Sean Callahan. Okay, you need to take me through this, like, name and connections deal here. So you had 2 horses in that Maryland Sire Stakes.
Yes.
Okay, so give me the names because they're a bit of tongue twisters for me.
Boo Boo Baba.
Okay.
And Ga Ga Gone.
Okay, so Boo Boo Baba, tell me about who's the owner on that one.
And my
tell
mother.
Okay, all right. And now Goo Goo Gone?
Ga Ga Gone.
Ga Ga Gone. So then the owner on that one is?
Court.
Okay, all right. So your mom owns one, Corey owns the other one.
Yes.
So your mom's horse actually won that race?
Yes.
Okay, so now who did you think was going to win going into the race?
Court.
All right. Now, do you have a favorite out of the two, though?
No, not really.
All right. Tell me about each one of them, like how they're different or how they're the same.
They're really pretty much both the same. They're both a little bit of a handful, a little strong in the mouth, but they're not bad in the race.
What did you think about the race tonight? I mean, I know it was a short field, but did you think that one was going to cut it, the other one going to get a perfect trip? I mean, how did you think?
It really lined up the way I thought it would. Just, I really thought Corey's mare, she's got good gait speed. I really thought she could cross right over.
1 minute!
And I thought Junior would let her go and follow around there and go to the wire and see who wins.
All right. What did your dad say after the race? He seemed extremely happy. I think he was giving digs to Corey. Not only did he win, but he got to give it to his son a little bit.
He made twice as much money. He should be happy.
That's right. Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Big win already. Big win and second. Good for you.
Thank you.
Moving on, it's our Maryland 4 and 5-year-old male trotters going for a purse of $13,000 in their final.
By 5/8 and head to 3/4, and Hybrid Henry leads the quintet, and it's just over 1. What that is continues closer to the outside. There goes Chucky DeVee. 3/4, 1:27 and 3. Head into the far turn for the final time. Hybrid Henry in complete control. It's a length and a half. What that is now starts to inch closer. 2 lengths back to Chucky DeVee. Less than an eighth to trot, and they're on their way home. And Hybrid Henry's the target from the pocket. Here comes What That Is. Hybrid Henry all out. What That Is the outside. Hybrid Henry, What That is a winner.
What That Is, bred by Richard Hands, benefited from a garden spot journey to pick up the win. The son of Cam's Rocket crossed the wire in 1:58 with driver Roger Plant Jr. What That Is visited Victory Lane with an elated owner-trainer, Carrie Welty.
First of all, it's so cool they have these Maryland Sire Stakes races for older horses.
Yes.
And you're still on cloud 9. Actually, your horse has already won, bathed, everything.
Yep. Harness washed.
And you're still smiling. Congratulations.
Right.
How cool is this?
Yeah, it's pretty awesome.
Tell me about the race and how you felt during the race and how the trip unfolded
nervous.
For you.
I'm usually always nervous. He sat in the two hole, so that's always good. He hasn't been quite as competitive this year, so he's been a little bit of a letdown for me, but it works out tonight.
But not today, right?
Yeah, so he made up for this year so far.
How is he like as far as being in the barn and his personality? And what kind of horse is he?
Pain in the butt.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Okay.
He's humongous, so he walks me everywhere. And let's see, he's not too bad at home here. He's a little bit rambunctious.
Okay.
The open paddock, I think, kind of gets him a little rowdy.
Oh, yeah. It is nice being at the ocean. It is open, but I know for a lot of horses.
Yeah, something like
there's that. There's so much to look at. They're so curious.
Right.
Now, your cousin is the breeder, right? And that's Richard?
Richard, yes.
Okay. So now, what is your connection as far as the breeding? Like, who's the sire? Who's the dam?
So, it's a pacing stallion.
Okay.
Name's Rocket, bred to a trotting broodmare.
Okay.
So it's a hybrid breed, like Goo Goo Gaga.
Okay.
And then my brother Brian owned him, and I bought him this year from Brian.
All right. So. Oh, that is so cool.
And we have the stallion at the farm, so it's pretty nice.
Oh, that is nice. Yeah, because we just want to explain to everybody, like, you are from a legacy of harness racing, you know, people.
A long line.
A long line.
Right.
Well, let's do a quick, like, Brady Bunch family tree type deal. So your mom is?
Judy Welty.
Okay. Who has been a trailblazer in this sport.
Yes.
Okay.
She's kind of phased out. She retired.
And Richard, then your uncle is?
Roger Hands.
Okay. All right.
Sandy Hands is my aunt. Arlene Cameron would be my cousin. Richard Hands is my other cousin. Brian Emerson is my brother. And my other brothers used to drive too, but they kind of retired from the sport. So
okay,
everybody right. at one point was involved.
So in every vein in your body, there's harness racing.
Yeah.
Yeah, very much.
Yeah. Born and raised.
Well, congratulations. Big win. So happy for you.
Thank you.
Next up, we'll bring in our 4 and 5-year-old lady pacers in Maryland Sired Action.
Around the turn, down the back stretch and head to 3/4. Cool Toy yet to face a challenge. Wagner tugs on the right line and Rissy's All In is on the attack. 3 lengths back to Max Kenna and Whitesville Michelle. 3/4, 128-2. Far turn, final time. Cool Toy along the inside. Grimly hangs on. It's only ahead. Rissy's All In ratchets up the pressure. 4, 5 lengths back to Max Kenna and Whitesville Michelle. Less than an eighth of pace and they're on their way home. Cool Toy turns first. Rissy's All In continues on the outside. Cool Toy. Rissy's All In surging late. Cool Toy hanging on.
Cool Toy went from wire to wire and held on to win by a nose for trainer Elwood Tigner in 157-1. The daughter of Cool Flying Fun was bred by Nick Callahan. And in this race, Breakaway Racing picked up another stakes win as an owner. Let's hear more about this victory from driver Justin Vincent.
Justin, it was a short field, so is that how you assumed the race was going to be? You're just going to lead the way around?
Well, I was hoping so. She was a nice mare last year, and then the last few months she quite hasn't been herself. So Elwood had been working on her and gave her some time off, and she qualified last week like her old self. So I was hoping if I could leave out of there and get the run, she would be like her old self and win. So.
You know, I saw she had almost a month off.
Yeah.
There was no worries about that, I guess.
No, he's been keeping her pretty tight, and like I said, she qualified last week, so she was back to her old self. I think the time off actually helped her.
Oh, okay, good. Well, how about her? I don't know if her attitude is the same, like, you know, when she's in the paddock or in the barn or whatever, but I know in the winner's circle, she was a bit feisty.
Yeah, she can be like that. If everything doesn't go her way, it can get pretty bad, and I had to come off the track and change bikes because I had a flat tire, and then John, he had to come off the track for a head pull or something like that, so everything that could have gone wrong went wrong, so luckily it all worked out.
That was quite a stretch duel.
Yeah.
Did you know you had it? It was
well,
tight, right?
I was hoping when John, he came a little early there at the 3/4 pole, and she kind of grabbed right onto me, so I was hoping she was going to fight till the end, and she did, so it worked out good.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
And finally, for our 4 and 5 year old divisions, let's check out those male pacers in their $13,300 final.
They're by the half, 57-3. The lead has just changed hands again. Jack Quick and Jason Thompson with a power move in front of the grandstand take the lead from Allie's Finale. Towards the inside, Lloyd's all in. The early leader is back to third. On the outside, here comes BT's Breeze and Vic Kirby, and they mean business. Fourth, third, second, and up the challenge. Jack Quick full the lead. Back to the outside, Lloyd's all in makes his second move of the mile. Four lengths back to Easy Pass B, Cool Flying Charlie, and Zach the Man. Three quarters, 126-2. Head into the far turn for the final time. Jack Quick, the inside, the lead a half a length. BT's Breeze turns up the pressure in second. That pair now have 6 lengths along the inside alley's Finale. They turn for home. Jack Quick is the target. On the outside, BT's Breeze. Jack Quick at the edge of the tote board. BT's Breeze can't reach. Jack Quick gets the money.
Jack Quick made a first over move, got to the top, and stayed there as they crossed the finish line and won 54-4. The breeder, owner, and trainer on this winning son of Nuclear Breeze is Basil Sapienza. And post time, caught up with the driver, Jason Thompson, after this big win. Jason, tell me how the race unfolded for you.
I had to rail. I was 1-5. I thought I'd get a little more respect, but 3-4 people left. So then they did a lot of shuffling on the front. And when Roger went to remove at the 3/8 pole, I just followed him and brushed the front. That horse has got such an unbelievable brush, it's ridiculous. Like, he can go, like, right now. So I just rushed to the front and ended up on the front from Maryland.
Yeah, it was quite a big field. I mean, there were 7 horses. When you went into the race, I mean, you had enough confidence, obviously.
Yeah, I mean, I went first up. First time I ever heard him, I went first up 51 at Rosecroft back at the end of the meet. I come 26 up the backside just in the grips and just cleared the front and, you know, 79 time mark. He's got plenty of speed. It's just we got some quirks need to be worked out, and, you know, so we're working on that.
Tell me about Basil a little bit. I don't know Basil Sapienza.
I drove a couple for him when I first started driving 6 years ago. I haven't drove much for him lately, and then I drove a filly that he had that wasn't much, and I got him a couple checks, and then Jonathan picked off this horse for his sisters one night, and he gave me the call on it, and I come first up and win, and since then, you know, he's kept putting me up, so.
Very cool. Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations to all the outstanding 2019 Maryland Sire Stakes winners at Ocean Downs.